to Ohaiyo Nation Deep Dive, where I interview everyone in the Ohaiyo Nation. And today, the person I'm going to interview is Herpes. Say hello, Herpes.
Hello, Ohaiyo Nation.
Okay, so today I have really sad news about our God Emperor Wada.
What?
He passed away right after I did the interview, as you all know.
Oh, yeah.
Because of his meme cancer.
Yes, because everybody definitely watched and listened to that interview.
Absolutely. There's a story to this.
Okay.
So he got a rare form of cancer, which is a meme cancer, where memes got control of his body and took control of everything until he died.
Mm-hmm.
And now we are trying to interview every single person of Ohaiyo Nation to find who is the best for being the new God Emperor Lord of Ohaiyo Nation.
Oh, that's just not me.
Yeah.
I don't care nearly enough about Ohaiyo Nation for that.
But fuck. You are a candidate, so you're going to be interviewed. So, Herpes, first of all, let's talk about Ohaiyo Nation.
Yeah.
What do you think of it, and how do you see yourself in it?
It's my new Discord group. It is a nice Discord group. There are a lot of guys I really do like in this Discord group. I don't quite remember their names, because I don't... No, listen here. Yeah, like, it's the same thing as an anime. I don't really remember, like, characters by their names. I remember them by their faces, and in this case, their profile pictures. I remember them by how they talk, and all that other dumb shit they do. Like, I remember, what is it? Fucking, that one chick, I think it's Blizzin. Like, she had Rory from Gate. And she had, like, she just posts all the good stuff in Not Safe for Work.
Okay, oh.
And Brandon also posts a lot of fun stuff.
Okay.
And then there's Denial and company. But yeah, like, they're a lot of fun people. Although I will say, like, they're very different from the kind of people I usually, like, hang along with. Because they're very open with their emotions. I don't know.
You're not comfortable with that?
Like, I'm not... It's just not the first thing I would do. Like,
yeah.
even with like, close friends, I don't usually, like, just open up emotionally like that. If I have a shitty day, I'm going to say I have a shitty day.
You have Wada, which you basically live with.
Yeah.
He's, like, really open with his emotions.
I don't think he is, though. Like, not with me. Like, he...
Well,
he's
not as open as Morten, but he's pretty open with his emotions compared to you.
But he's more open with his emotions online than he is with me. Like, there are times when he just, like, opens up with his emotions with me. But, like, I very rarely do the same. Maybe I'm just one of those, like, psycho cases that, like, just bottle up their emotions and, like, release all at once.
Yes, absolutely.
Very possible.
What was the name of the... It doesn't matter.
Oh, fuck it. Taking time bombs.
Yeah. Sure.
Yeah.
After we talk about Ohaiyo Nation, I want to ask you, what do you do and what did you do in college?
Okay. So, I flip old people, as Wada has said lovingly many, many times. What this actually means is that I go to other people's houses and help them out with various things that they need to do. All of them, like, most of them are just old people, yes. So, but, yeah. And, I don't know, like, I talk to them, I help them make food. Sometimes I actually do flip them.
Like, on the bed, you mean?
Yeah, flip them on the bed, flip them up on their chair and shit like that. And sometimes I like to, you know, just, like, make them do a backflip just for shits and giggles.
Okay. What did you do in college? Compared to what you're doing right now.
Hold on, I just need to see. So, like, I don't think I've actually finished college.
Okay.
You
don't think?
Because I'm not really sure. Because it's called, college here is called Högskolan. It's high school.
Okay.
Right? I'm pretty sure. I think so. Because, like, okay. So, like, you have elementaries, right?
Yeah.
And then you have, like, 7th, 9th grade.
Yeah.
And then you have something else. Like, that thing afterwards.
The university. That's what I'm talking about.
That's university?
No, college is university.
Oh, like,
that's what I'm asking.
Yeah, I've done some courses, but I haven't really, like, finished any class or whatever the fuck it's called. I've done...
haven't done the old people flipping college, no?
No, I haven't. I've got sociology and psychology, like, the first part of the three-part thing, but I haven't gotten the second part of either.
Okay.
That's it. That's why I've been in university. I did in high school, though, like... Or, like, whatever, whatever is before university, I did the technology with a focus on design and architecture.
Okay.
So it's very different from what I'm working with now.
Okay. Are you part of any other groups other than Ohaiyo Nation? Do you want to talk about them?
I guess I could. Like, I mean, Wattis talked about his online group.
About sobriety and...
No, Wattis
talked about his sobriety. No, he talked about his sobriety group in here. He didn't talk about his anime group in the interview.
Okay, in the interview. But, like, I talked about the anime group sometime. It, like, before, it was just a nice, quaint little gathering of me and two other guys. And we just watched anime. Like, mostly whatever I brought. Like, sometimes they'd say, hey, why don't we watch this? And we said, yeah, sure, why not? Let's watch this. And then we just, like... I don't know, just somehow, like, we talked during some meeting, right? And then, like, some other guys just heard it and say, hey, you guys were watching it, talking about anime? Yeah, you know, we sometimes watch it at this guy's place. Hey, sweet, can I be with you? Yeah, sure, why not? And they just grew bigger and bigger, and then suddenly there's seven people there. And then, like, three people.
Seven people? So yeah. You, Wara, and I've seen Patrick.
Yeah, you've seen Patrick. Oliver wasn't even a part of it. He joined later.
Okay.
Yeah, so it was me, Wara, Spanish P, and then it was, like, the two main guys, Big P and Robert, or Mr. Interesting.
Mr. Interesting?
Dude, fucking getting feedback from him was like squeezing water from a
it's interesting.
Every time, like, you go say, oh, you're a bit quiet, like, what did you think of the show, hey, Mr. Interesting? It was interesting. That's it. Like, fuck. He laughed, though. Like, you could tell he was enjoying it or something. Like, he laughed.
He was in on the joke.
Yeah, but no, I mean, like, just when he was watching the show, like, you could tell if he was enjoying it or not, but either fucking way, like, even if he fucking hated it, like, even if he was, like, just kind of sitting here, like, pulling out his phone, and we were just asking him, he was like, that's interesting. It's yeah. Like, fucking
hell. It was his I Am Groot, right?
Yeah, pretty much.
Yes, it was.
No, but, he opened up later, like, when you actually talked to him one-on-one, he was just like, he just had social anxiety or whatever the fuck it was. He's a cool guy. What was it? Yeah, then there was, Yeah, it was Wada's other guy. It was David. He's in the surf as well. Like, what the fuck is he called?
David?
Destinum. Yeah, and then there was some other fucker.
Wasn't Johannes there?
Yeah, it was Jonathan. No, Johannes was there a couple times, but he was such a fucking flake, so he just, like, kind of flaked out.
That's Jackson, by the way.
Yeah, Jackson. Yeah, yeah. But no, there was Jonathan as well, who was just, like, the less interesting Mr. Interesting.
The less interesting Mr. Interesting.
Yes, because, like, he's still in the group now, but he won't fucking say anything. Like, he's trying to half-heartedly take this Mr. Interesting role, but he just doesn't really have opinion, even if you talk to him one-on-one.
Oh,
so it's just,
yes.
Like, kind of like, okay.
Jackson needs to, his name changed to... The less interesting mystery.
No, that's Jonathan. That's another dude.
Oh, Jonathan?
Yeah,
okay,
yeah.
Okay.
No, Jackson was... I don't know. I guess. I never really talked to him about much about anime. Mostly about real life stuff.
Okay.
Yeah, all
right. Other than that, I want to ask you about your hobbies.
My hobbies?
Watching anime, for one.
Well, yeah, watching anime with the what is pretty fun. I play games sometimes.
What are, like, your favorite games?
I think it's weird to say, but probably just mostly strategy games now.
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah, like, I got really into StarCraft somehow. I don't even know how. Like,
I never talked about StarCraft before.
And then, like, fucking what, out of the blue one day, one of these old friends of mine said, like, hey, like, let's just play some StarCraft. And I was like, but dude, money. I don't buy games. I pirate them or I play them online for free, whatever. And then he was like, dude, it's free right now. I was like, wait, seriously? It's always free. And then I played it. It was really fun.
Have you ever played other strategy games?
Yeah, I mean, I played Warcraft 3. I fucking sucked at it. But then afterwards, I went back to it and it was really fun again.
You're awesome.
And then, like, before that, I spent, like, God knows, I don't know, like, 1,500 hours on XCOM.
What do you mean? You say strategy? You mean just RTS? Like
No. Like fucking XCOM.
XCOM. Yeah, there you go.
I mean, I've played FTL too. I played fucking hours in FTL.
I usually think of that more of a roguelike than an actual strategy game. But
as a what?
As
a
roguelike.
Oh well, sure, but like it's still very strategic.
Yeah, it's a strategy game, but the fact that it's a roguelike comes in my mind before. Yeah.
I think like the big thing about like FTL and like the fact that it's, in my mind, at least more strategical, is the fact that there's a fucking pause button.
Yeah.
Yeah, and all these fucking little nuances that you have to do. Enough talking about games. Besides that, like...
Do you watch movies?
Hmm? Oh, yeah, I do watch movies. I do watch movies quite a bit. Like, there's still that fucking movie, I think it was Pondered Air. Like, he said I should watch this, and I downloaded it, and I just never watched it, because it was late and I wanted to go to sleep. But, yeah, like, otherwise, I just usually watch movies, like Tarantino movies, just the normal ones. What is it? It's Tarantino, it's...
I can't help you. I don't know.
Yeah,
what,
no,
you,
that,
what you're trying to say.
There's that fucking movie by, what is it? The guy who made Thor 3.
Oh,
What's the Sneaky? What's Sneaky?
Waikiki. Waikiki.
He's a really good one. But, yeah, like mostly Tarantino ones, I guess.
Okay.
Yeah.
Like, I guess anything other than consuming media. Do you do anything?
Like, I bike. I listen to music. And bike stupidly fast.
Well, listening to music is consuming media, so.
Well, I guess, yeah, but, like, you fucking, like, you know when you listen to...
But, like, you bike to get to places. You don't bike just as a hobby,
Like, the fact that I bike so fucking much might as well be a hobby, though.
Okay.
Because I do like when I bike.
Okay.
But, yeah, just as a hobby, no, nothing much. I guess I go to the gym sometimes. I should go to the gym more, because Tanjiro's gonna fucking beat my ass if he ever found out I actually go to the gym. And, like, just was with me. But, yeah. Fuck.
You want to talk about, is that enough about hobbies? Do you have anything to add?
I think there's one more thing, although I guess it's not really much of a hobby. Like, whenever I go to the military and shit.
Oh, what?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, you went to the military. Like,
no, I still go to the military. Like, twice every year.
Okay.
Yeah, I could go more, but I just usually prioritize groups.
What do you
do
there?
No, we just, like, do ordinary training, like, group training mostly. Like, make sure that we have,
Just so you can stay fit, or...
No, just so we got the basic group training covered. Like, you know, so that we can cover each other's flanks, like, fucking work as a group, take down objects, like, go over field.
Like, are you enlisted? Like, if Sweden would go to war, would you be a soldier?
Yeah, although, like, most of the time it's just, like, if there's a giant fire, you have to go, like, you should go help.
Okay.
Mm. Like, take time off work, go help them.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Is it not?
Yeah, that happened. Okay. That happened this year as well.
Okay. Is that it?
Yeah.
Okay. Let's talk about your family. Do you want to talk about that? Because you have like an interesting story of.
I have a family.
You have a family.
However, I have a.
And your family has an aesthetic.
However, no. However, I wish they did. No, I just have a fucked up family. Like I have also a very small family for some reason. Like I don't know anybody outside of like my very closest relatives.
Okay.
So, like, I know my own family, like, my dad, mom, and my siblings. I know, like, one of each cousin. Like, one family on my mom's side and one family on my dad's side. And that's it. I don't know anything outside of that.
Yeah, but I was trying to, I wanted you to talk about, like, your story with your family. Like, where were you born and how were you raised?
That's true, because, okay.
Are you fine with that?
Yeah, sure, why not? So, I was born in America. In like fucking Rock Island, Illinois. Okay. And then I live in Wisconsin. I don't know how it happened. I guess I was also born in transit, like fucking what I love seeing. But yeah, then I just live in Wisconsin for a couple of years. I don't really get to see my dad because he's off working wherever. He works with ABB as an engineer. I talk to my mom a bit, I guess, and most of that's pretty boring. I've moved down to Texas, and then I don't know, school gets rough, shit starts hitting the drain, and don't know, like it's my like I get a couple of siblings, I get a neighbor that's a pretty good friend.
When did you move to Sweden?
Before 12, 13.
12? Okay, so you're like in middle school.
Yeah, I was in like end of fifth grade.
Not yet high school, right?
No.
You did high school here.
Yeah, I did all high school. But I did like miss all of the whole like this is our nation the shit they do in elementary school. So I know pretty much nothing about fucking Sweden.
Awesome, amazing. You're not obsessed with the Swedish flag.
No, I'm not obsessed with the Swedish flag.
Unlike other Swedish people.
Yes, unlike fucking Wada. And Wada loves to rub his face into it. Like, you're like, oh, you're not fucking Swedish. You're Asian unless it fits my agenda or it fits the joke. And then you're Swedish.
Or American as
yes,
well.
Yes, of course. No, but no, the shit just in the fan when mostly around my mother whenever we come to Sweden. Like, I swear to God, like, first she gets really obsessed with fucking computer games. Like, she was a house mother before all of this.
Okay.
Gets really obsessed with computer games. I just catch her, like, fucking going out onto BDSM sites, like, all the fucking time.
What computer games?
No, RuneScape.
Oh, okay, awesome.
Like, it's a patrician
computer game. People in the Discord who are gonna love that.
Oh, yeah, dude, it's great. I even showed her and everything. Like, she's still, like, even now she still asks my fucking help for it. But, like, she got addicted. Like, I still remember this one time that was so fucking clearly. So, like, we're in the car, and then I'm saying, okay, mom, I know, like, I want to get on the computer when I get home. And she's like, oh, yeah, sure. We get home, she, like, fucking just rips open the car door, runs in, like, unlocks the door, because he has the fucking key. He gets on, and he's like, but mom, I said, you said I was going to get on the computer. No, fuck off. I was like, what the fuck? It was at this point we kind of figured that she might have a problem with computer games.
Okay.
And she had to like kind of stop, like, you know, tone it down a bit. And she kind of stopped. She didn't stop cold turkey, but she after a while she did stop. But then, yeah, like, there are a lot of problems with my mom. I could fucking go on forever. Like, her drinking problem, her, like, fucking divorces and shit. Yeah, it's dumb.
Why did you, why did your family move to Sweden?
We moved right here, just in Västerås.
Like, why?
Oh, why? So my dad worked for ABB before, right?
Yeah.
And he lived in America.
What's ABB?
ABB, it's a big-ass company. I don't fucking know what they do.
It's a big-ass company. They do nothing. Okay, they work with them. They make money.
They make money. They press a button and they make money. Exactly. No, but like, what is it? They make electronics. They enlist pretty much all the engineers. They make factories. I think they work most with, like, making electricity and shit like that. I know they make robots as well.
Okay.
Yeah. But yeah, like, was it the ABB in Texas, like, offered my dad a stable job that so he didn't have to, like, fucking fly away for 6 months and then he'd have to not see his family again. So he said, yeah, sure, why not? So now okay. He's just, like, staying with us.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So other than that, you have, like, how many siblings?
I have 3 siblings. I have
two sisters and Oliver.
Yeah, 2 sisters and Oliver. Okay, dude.
Yeah.
I feel pretty secure about my sisters, but Oliver, I feel a bit spooked about Oliver, I'll be honest.
Spooked? What do you mean?
As in, like,
is he gonna shoot up school?
Like, he talks about it way too much.
About school shootings?
Yes.
Oh my god.
Yeah. Like, you know, what is it? There's this one song, like, all you little kids with the pumped up kicks, better run.
Yeah. Faster than my bullets. Yeah, I'll run my gun.
And he's really fascinated with the subject. And he says, I'm fascinated.
Have you ever shown him Monkey Jones?
No, I haven't.
Oh, you don't know what that is?
I know what it is. Wada fucking showed it to me 50 times. I know what it is.
Okay.
But, he's fascinated in it because he really likes... he doesn't really like... He's fascinated with the idea that they kill themselves afterwards because he's just, like, got this idea in his head that all people who commit suicide are, like, weaklings. And he's just like, what the fuck? I don't know. He's a specialist.
Who don't commit suicide who
commit suicide. They're
all weaklings.
Okay. Yes. And they should not be pitied, is what is his theory. And he's just like, Jesus Christ. There's some stuff like that. He's like, yeah. Otherwise, like, he's a bit, you've seen, he's a bit antisocial. He doesn't really know how to work in society. Like, there was this one time where I was, like, I was showing him where he was going to go to get his driver's license and shit. And, like, I started calling the number, gave him the phone. He was, like, really fucking spooked, holding the phone to his head, against his head. And then they answered, and they just immediately hung up. But shit like that. So, yeah, I'm a bit spooked about that. My other sister's, like, they're great, although, like, one's a fucking hypocrite and she's kind of a bitch, but, like, you act a bit nice to her and, like, she stops being such an asshole. And the other one's just, like, I forgot, my littlest sister was an actual psychotic case.
What?
Yeah, because, like, maybe I'm over-exaggerating, but, like, she's been spoiled to death by our mother, and then, like, she's been kind of bullied by us because we feel that she gets too much attention. And, like, all I remember is this one time where she got really pissed at my other little sister, at Anna, right? And then she just, like, fucking drags out a knife from the kitchen drawer and starts running towards her. And we just, like, this isn't okay. We just, like, fucking have to restrain her. It feels like we had to fucking, like, tie her up in a jacket or some shit. And that was the spookiest part.
Oh god.
Yeah, that was a bit spooky. But she's mellowed out. She got into She got into the fuck is it called? The Royal Ballet Academy. So yeah, you
okay. Got that. So now we've talked about how your siblings are and parents are psychotic nat cases. Yeah,
should we talk about how I'm psychotic?
Exactly.
Yes. How am I psychotic? I guess I have an issue with, like, people throwing away food.
Okay, don't talk about that later. But
we can talk about that later.
I just want to talk about, like, are there any like actual medical things about you that people should know? Like, have
that
you
I've checked up? Help? No. That no? checked up? No.
Okay.
Although, like, fuck, I probably have something.
No mental health problems.
Not that I know.
Actually had, like, water.
No.
Okay. What about, like, actual health problems? Have you ever had any problems?
Diabetes too.
Oh really?
Yeah.
Do you still have it, or?
I don't think so.
Yeah, okay.
Like, my mom said I have diabetes too, and as long, like, when I was born, and then it kind of went away because I was like a healthy kid after that.
Okay.
But apparently I'm going to have to deal with that when I'm older.
Oh, God.
Yeah.
Yeah. Right. Prepare for the insulin. Okay.
Yep. But, yes?
I was going to ask you, I'm going to ask you a little bit about YouTube. What is your interaction with YouTube? But I really want to know what is your interaction with the internet in general? What do you watch?
It's 4chan. Yeah, it's 4chan, and then whenever I'm on YouTube, I'm just listening to music, or I'm listening to, like, I don't know, Crip talk about Hearthstone and, like, maybe some videos, or just, like, Sing Sing being a dumbass.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's okay. Most of that. There's like,
so biggest.
And then whenever like I guess no, like I watch whenever like you know Donkey uploads something.
Okay.
It's like besides that, I don't really follow any YouTubers at all.
Okay. What about Digi? What do you know, and what is your relationship with Digi?
All right. So like, I don't think I have a relationship with Digi at all because like I don't know him. Like I've watched the videos that like what is it like I see a really long conversation about something in the Ohio Nation.
Yeah.
I usually watch, and it's about a Digi video. I usually watch the Digi video. Like, okay. What was it? There was, We Are Accepting Mediocrity?
Yeah, We Are Accepting Mediocrity.
Yeah, I watched that entire thing, and like, I was not a big fan of it because
neither were we. Yeah. Most of us weren't.
Yeah, but it's not that I saw a couple of it, like, he was just reusing old videos and stuff. Like, it felt like stuff he was already saying.
Yeah.
I just wasn't really agreeing with what he was saying because he was just comparing to, like, television shows to fucking like 1990s opiates.
Yeah.
And especially with this fucking like, what was it? He was ragging on Sword of the Stranger, right?
Right.
Yeah, and like he was just like taking these inconsequential fucking background characters that were like kind of rushed on and saying like, because of this show or this movie is not a masterpiece as it should strive to be. All movies should be masterpieces or they are worthless. I was like, fuck off. Holy shit.
All right.
Yeah, I don't really agree with Digi too much and shit.
Okay.
Yeah.
What are your favorite creators on the internet in general? Do you have any? Other than Crip? Is it Crip even your...
Not really. I like his... Like, no, like, the thing is, Crip is a fun dude. He, like, streams. He's not really the one that makes his stuff. It's like his wife edits his videos and stuff.
Yeah.
Like, so, yeah. But, like, otherwise, just, like... It's just edits and shit like that. Not really, besides Donkey. Donkey's like, pretty nice. There is another guy. There is, what is it? You Suck at Cooking. He's pretty cool.
Okay.
Yeah. He just, like, makes these really nice pieces about, well, just cooking. And, like, he makes them humorous. It's like, you've seen How to Basic, right?
No, I don't.
You don't? Well, you've seen, like, you know the concept of his video.
I have no idea.
All right. It's this crazy guy who says, like, he puts up these clickbait articles, like, fucking how to bake.
Oh, and he hits him with the camera or something.
No,
right?
No. He like says how to bake a cake, and then like he starts like throwing eggs in a bowl.
Yeah. He throws eggs and everything.
But like in the end, like you still kind of get the concept of how to make the cake, right?
Yeah.
Like you just like throw in some eggs, put in some milk, put in some sugar, like put in the oven, because like he always puts that dumb shit. Like he always goes through the procedures. Like, what is it? You Suck at Cooking is kind of like that, except it's just chill, and it's also like, you know, he says the completely wrong names. He doesn't give you an ingredients list, but he still goes through the right procedures, and like he still like shows the final product. It's just fun. It's just a fun way without like having these, you know, boring ass, I don't know, like, first you put 3 eggs in here, right, and then you put that. He's like, it's like not a Facebook video. It is LARP. It's fine.
Okay.
Well.
So I want to talk about, let's do favorite anime. Top 3, want to talk about them?
I don't have a list of my top 3 anime.
You don't have, no. Even number 1?
No, I'll tell you.
Want to talk about that? Why you don't have it?
Well, sure, I just, like, I watch anime, and I either like it, I remember it, I can discuss about it, but I don't really like just putting them in a list of, like, how much I enjoyed it. It's just, like...
You're not even the one that
because they're so different and I enjoy them for all these different reasons. Like, even if there's something that, like, it just feels like I'm putting everything on a pedestal at that point that it just feels so elitist and somehow, like, I will never be able to enjoy anything as good as this. Or I should strive to find something, like, because then I'm going to have to compare this one show to something complete from any other completely different medium. And it just feels like, I'm like, okay, so say that I have Flying, which is my number one, right?
Yeah.
Then I'm gonna have to compare every other show that might want to be better than Flying Witch to Flying Witch. So you say it's just an action show. How the fuck am I supposed to compare an action show to Flying Witch?
Right.
Because it could just be, like, stuff I enjoy more in Flying Witch, and, like, I don't enjoy as much in that in the action show. It's just fucks.
Okay.
If I was going to make a list, it'd probably just be, like, you know, a list of fucking my favorites in each genre, if anything. But then it's also fucked, because, like, then I have to put every show in a specific genre. It's fucked. I don't really like the listing system. I'd much rather just have, like, should you watch it? Yes, no. I'd much rather have that.
Okay. So enough about your history. Let's go into the next statement.
All right.
So, right now, we're going to talk about your approach to everyday life. How do you function? How do you... What's your mentality when something in your life happens?
You're going to have to get me with anything. Tell me anything. What happens in my life? Say, give me one thing. No. Not like that. Like, okay, say you go to work. Say that. Say you go to work, you're late for work. Anything. I need something to react to. I have all of these answers in my hand, but I can't play any of these unless I can react it, like, unless I know what I'm...
Can't you, like, see the commonality in all of them and tell me what the general mentality of them is?
Like, the general mentality is deal with the problem.
Right.
If I'm, like, if I have free... Like, there's a difference if I have free time and if I have something I need to do.
Okay.
Like, say, okay, if I have something I need to do, I just fucking, like... Just make sure I have what I need. I have my phone, I have my headset, and I'm like my keys. I'm good to go. And then I just do whatever I need to do. Unless it's something I need to do for myself, then I'm fucked. Like, right. If I need to, like, fix my bike, yeah, fuck that. If I need to, like, I don't know, buy a house, I'm screwed.
Yeah.
If I need to go to work, though, that's another thing, because then I know people are,
because,
like,
you're forced.
Yeah, it'll also just be, like, people are, like, you know, depending on me. If I don't go to work, it's just fucked for them.
Yeah.
It's, like, stuff like that. But otherwise, like, if I have free time, I just, like, I don't know, I just get chill. I get as comf as fucking possible. Okay.
What if, like, what do you do in case of, like, extreme events? What is your mentality with that? What's the first thing you think of?
Give me an extreme event.
Well, say that you go bankrupt and you don't have any money. What would you do?
I just cut off all means of, like, fucking spending money.
Right.
I just take my computer, go live at my mom's, and try to find a job again. Like, if I get fired, of course. Otherwise, I just, like, continue fucking working. Because I spend, like, besides what I've spent here, I don't usually spend money.
Right.
At all.
That's, okay.
I just, like, okay, like, either I eat at my dad's all days of the week and just, like, fuck around.
You live at Waters.
No.
Other days of the week.
Yeah, other days of the week. But then, like, if I'm bankrupt, then I'm just going to have to, like, just mooch off of water. He doesn't really have money, so I'd probably just, like, eat my dad's.
Yeah.
But, yeah, like, that's all I do. Like, I guess. Like, I don't know. I don't really have a lot to lose right now, honestly. Like, I have, a fat stack in my bank, but I don't really have anything I need to spend it on at the moment.
Right. Again, we're going to talk about this later,
sure.
But we're just going to move on to the next topic,
mm-hmm.
Which is how do you approach people? How do you think of them? How do you act around them? How do you get friends? How do you keep them? How do you get enemies, and how do you deal with them? All, like, of these questions.
I think I try to be as sociable as possible, but I think what I mostly try to do is just, like, see the... Especially with my job, because I have to meet some new customers sometimes.
Yeah.
And it's just, like, I don't know, you just introduce yourself, you see how you can help them, see what you can do. I don't fucking know. Like, you try to see them as a person, because they're going to be, like, no matter what they are, if they're angry, if they're irritable, if they're happy, you just try to see them as a person, like, try to be nice, I guess.
How did you end up meeting Wara and, like, the other people of the anime club and
the anime,
be
like,
able to, like, be, like, so
mostly,
close to them?
I think it's easier, like, it is probably just easier for me when, like, I see them as beneath me.
And, okay.
Yeah, because, like, I'll be honest, I saw, like, the guys in my anime club, I saw them as beneath me.
Okay.
Because I felt like I was in a higher power position. And as such, I could be the benevolent emperor, more or less. I could just be the guy who shows them
the
all...
The god lord.
Yeah, pretty much. The god lord of anime. I could just, yeah, like, show them all this cool shit. I could show them, like, fucking... All the cool shit they've never seen before. Like, then they, like, you know how I fucking blew Wada's mind with, like, showing him, like, that seasonal anime was a thing.
Really?
Yeah. Like, he didn't know about that before I told him about it. It was like, yeah, what are you watching this season? He was like, what's the season? Well, you see. And I just explained what season was about. And he was like, his mind was fucking blown. It's like, it's easier for me when I just see them as blown, because then I can just, like, help them with everything. And see, I can just, it's so easy when you, like, when they don't know anything. Because then you can just, like, give them stuff and they're going to think you're the coolest guy.
Yeah, you see a person who wants something and you realize you have it. Exactly. And then they're your friend.
Exactly.
Awesome.
Yeah, this is just how you do it.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. But, like, then afterwards, like, when it's somebody, like, above you, then you, like, it's a bit harder. But, like, I don't know. Then you just, like, try to be amiable. I don't know. I think the only time I've really gotten, like, there's been a couple times where I feel like I've gotten an equal relationship between people. Mm-hmm. Which is weird, because that's kind of what I want to get to. I want to get to an equal relationship with everybody. Everybody I know, at least. Except maybe my mom, because my mom would probably try to fuck me over or something.
Well, you kind of are in the High Nation Club, right?
With what?
You're kind of in an equal relationship with Wara and the rest of the people in the
High Nation. No, not even in High Nation. Not with, like, anybody except maybe Ash. Like, not even Ash. Like, fuck. I feel so fucking inferior to everybody in High Nation. So fucking inferior, dude. I swear to God, any time I just post my opinion, people are just gonna kind of wave it away because they think, like, yeah, fucking, what, this fucking Herpes guy? Yeah, he has no fucking taste. They're just gonna say he has bad taste.
Yeah.
Which is so fucked, because I just, like, have it in my life to try to enjoy anything as much as I can.
Yeah.
But since I enjoy him at Maho Shoujo site, they're just gonna say, no, this guy has fucking bad taste. I can enjoy this shit. It's so fucking unaesthetic. And it looks bad, so it has
to be bad. It doesn't have an aesthetic.
No, it has an aesthetic. It just looks bad, and because of that, it is bad. It's just like, no, fuck off. Oh my God. It's just like, oh, fuck it. And I, like, the times like that where I don't really, like, want to be in High Nation, like, okay, fuck it.
Right.
Yeah.
What is your approach to politics?
My approach to politics is to slowly back away.
That's the best fucking answer, of course.
I fucking loathe politics. Politics is the new religion. That really is what it is. Before, people fucking centered their life around religion.
But what now about it's just becoming the issues?
Dude, I have so many issues right already in my life, and they want me to think about other issues. That's just not happening. I don't want to devote my brain power thinking about these poor, poor immigrants. And I don't want to, like, allocate even more brain power to, like, giving a nuanced opinion about these poor, poor immigrants. Because then I'm just going to have to find, the counter-arguments to everything as well. Yeah. It's just like, dude, fuck all of this. I already know what I believe in. I think all people should, like, try to be as equal to each other as possible. I don't really... I'd rather be a mindless sheeple just worrying about my own problems than, like, trying to fix the system. Right. I don't know.
Okay, so slowly back away.
Yeah, slowly back away.
From that question.
Yeah, this is
like, what is your approach to art?
What is my approach to art?
That is the question, yeah. Everyone wants to know.
Yeah, like, I'll say this. Like, I
the million-dollar question.
You remember how you were at the church, right?
Yeah.
Like, they showed these, like, these great, like, murals, right? They, like, they could close, and they had doors and shit, right? And there were, like, these little carvings on the inside.
Yeah.
It was, like, Jesus and all this other shit.
Jesus and shit, yeah.
Like, this fucking tour guide, he was rambling off about the fucking history of it and, like, when it was made and all this other dumb shit. I was like, I was just really interested in just, like, looking and trying to discern the fucking, like, actually understand what the fuck was going on inside of this fucking painting.
Right.
Because there was a lot of stuff, there were a lot of details to, like, take in and soak in. It was so hard because the lighting was bad and it was, like, it was a tour guide, so he kind of expected us to just fuck off to the next attraction after we were done. And, yeah, like, I don't know, I just kind of like to, I'd like to see the art as just the art piece, not the history behind it, but just as the art piece.
Right.
And, like, try to discern the, like, maybe not discern the meaning, but, like, maybe the technique and everything else made behind it.
Right. This is the final question of this segment. Mm-hmm. How do you see yourself in the world and in the group?
Which group?
In the Ohaiyo Nation group.
Oh,
I think you've probably answered the second one. Yeah, already, probably. But how do you see yourself in the world in general?
The world.
What is your vision of yourself? How would you describe yourself?
Some fucker in Sweden?
Yeah, but, like, that describes a lot of people. What describes you specifically, Herpes? Other than the simple word, Herpes.
I really don't know. Like, okay. I don't think about myself on the world scale. I don't think about the world scale because I try not to think about politics.
But what about in the group?
In the group, I've already said, I just feel myself like inferior to pretty much everybody.
Yeah, but what do you see that makes you special? Mm. What do you think makes you special?
Oh, in the group?
Yeah, and also in the world.
I don't subscribe to the digi religion. I guess that's the only real thing that's different.
The digital religion.
There's also, like, there is a surprising, like, I don't know what's the difference between left and right anymore. But, like, there is a very, very clear factor of, like, you know, like, not really SJW, but, like, you know, leaning towards that direction. I don't know if that's left or that's right.
Yeah.
But I feel like there's a very, like, there was that one time where...
There's no longer the political line. There's the political Mobius strip now.
Yeah, kinda. But, like, for example, there was this one time where, like, where we were talking about the trans and shit like that in Hawaii Nation. And, like, I kind of wanted to, like, just break it down. And, like, I was really fucking spooked about doing this as well. Because I was just, like, worried I was just going to get this giant fucking backlash. Because I felt like I saw this fucking trend before where they were just, like, being persecuted and everything else. And I just, like, kind of made a comparison to furries.
Okay.
Because, like, there's a persecution as well where the furries felt...
Persecution?
Yeah, actual thing. Okay. Actual thing.
Okay.
Where, like, where furries everywhere just, like, felt they were persecuted against and made a very big, like, you know, they made a riot about it, kind of.
Okay.
Yeah. They marched the streets and shit. But, yeah, it just felt like I was feeling the same thing, and I was really fucking spooked of saying that. And, like, shit like that feels like the only thing I could give to our nation. Like, just kind of more nuanced opinions on the other side of the political agenda, I guess. But besides that, funny 4chan jokes. That's it.
Okay, let's now move on to the special segment that is coming up next.
The meme segment.
Welcome everyone to the meme corner.
Hi.
Now, sadly, Herpes is not as far into meme cancer as Wada. He doesn't have as many memes.
Sadly.
Yeah. His memes have not consumed every single cell in his body.
Am I not to be a king on the throne for a longer time than Wada?
Yes.
If I just ingrained myself with all of the memes, then I wouldn't be a king for very long now, would I?
Of course.
Yes.
So the first meme, of course, is the fact that you have bad taste.
I don't have bad taste. It's just that everybody sees that I like a show they don't like, and they immediately see, oh, that guy must have bad taste. It's like, fuck you.
Well, the thing is that most people in Ohio Nation don't like most shows, and you like most shows.
Yes.
So, of course, you mostly like shows that other people don't like.
Yes.
So you have bad taste.
Yeah, because I like anime.
You like? Talking of which, what the fuck is anime?
Look, if you're speaking it in English, if you're writing it in English, then the I is hard. It's anime, isn't it?
But it's not in English.
I know, but like what? Are you saying that it's not called animation?
No one says it like that.
It's called animation, though.
No, it's called animation.
No, it is called animation.
No, it's called animation.
No, animation.
Animation.
We're just going to repeat the same thing back and
the
forth.
The I is soft. Like, it's animation.
But it's animation. I mean, there's an
it's
E.
It's like you skip the I.
Look, there's an E at the end of anime. Are you telling me that I'm wrong? Are you telling me that English is a stupid grammar, has stupid grammar rules that don't make sense half of the time?
Yeah. I mean, it's true. But if you're trying to shorten animation, then you know the animation, you might as well skip the I.
Yes, right? I know.
So you could say anime.
Look, I know it's fucking stupid.
Anime. Okay, that's stupid.
Yeah.
The other meme is the fact that, what the fuck are you? You're Swedish, you're Asian, you're...
Also American.
You're American. What the fuck? You're from Taiwan, right? Your parents are from Taiwan.
My dad is from Sweden, right?
Right.
My mom's from Taiwan.
Okay.
They met up, had me in a bar in Taiwan.
Oh, that's why your sister looks like she's Swedish. And
why?
Everyone else.
How?
Everyone else looks like
her
Chinese.
How?
I don't know. I've literally seen like a few seconds of her.
Yes, you've seen my little sister. You've seen both my little sisters. You've seen Oliver. Does Oliver look Asian?
Absolutely.
How the fuck? Okay.
What?
Okay.
Huh?
Sure. Whatever. Fuck it. Okay. How on earth? Like, we're all born in America, in the American States, in the United States. How the fuck How the fuck do my sisters not look Asian? And we look Asian.
No, one of your sister looks Asian. One of your sisters looks Swedish. And you two look Caucasian.
Oh my god. Whatever. Either way, yeah, my mom was from Taiwan. My dad's from Sweden. I was born in America. Grew up in America, that's why. That is why I'm American whenever it fits the joke. Or Swedish whenever, or Asian whenever it fits the joke.
Okay.
Yeah.
And this is the thing that we've been hinting at for all this time. The greatest meme of all time. The fact that you basically eat 99% leftovers.
Look, it's just a waste.
And that your brother, should I talk about that?
Yeah, sure.
The time he went to McDonald's.
What?
And ate like half-eaten burgers and french fries.
Look, dude. Look. We were hungry, all right?
You were what?
We were hungry, all right? Like, there's a perfectly good burger there. Why the fuck wouldn't we eat it?
Oh, my
there
God.
There's just a thousand reasons not to.
Oh my god.
I'll be honest, I don't really remember which time that was.
Literally, like a few days ago when we were drunk, we were talking about that with Oliver. Like, Oliver went on his way back from the docks and went to McDonald's and instantly, like, ate half-eaten burgers and fries.
Alright, like, okay, a half-eaten burger feels
really weird.
And you
were disgusted by it.
Yeah, I guess I was disgusted. Then why the fuck did you say I did? I thought I did.
I didn't say you. I said Oliver.
Okay. Yeah, because if Oliver did it, he's a fucking disgusting piece of shit.
But then one day later, you wake up and you look at the table and there's
there's untouched garlic.
No,
lying on the
it's not.
No, is it then?
No, not about the garlic. The garlic sauce that is hardened on the side of the the pan.
Yeah,
you just scrape that and shove it in your mouth.
It's good.
That is so disgusting.
It's good sauce, dude. It's nice, good sauce. Yeah, look. I'm sitting here eating breakfast in the morning, and I see some sauce on the side. I just say hey, why don't I just have some of that sauce? You know, it's good sauce.
Do you ever do you ever end up with people who eat so little that you end up eating all of their?
Yes.
Do you ever get too full for that?
Yes, I did. Like, dude,
and you still eat it.
Well, yeah. I mean, this literally happened when we first went out to eat at that fucking kebab place.
Yeah.
You remember?
Yeah.
Were you just so fucking picky and just ate all the chicken inside and didn't even touch the salad or the bread that came with it? You idiot. So I just asked. Are you gonna eat that bread? He's like, yeah, sure, why not? And I just fucking made another kebab because fucking Morton didn't want all the kebab on his kebab pizza. So I just took some of his kebab and just filled that up, and I had a second kebab.
You're too full to eat that, but you still ate it.
Well, I had to eat it. I can't just take this tiny little bit with me.
You had to eat it.
Well, yeah, I can't just throw it away.
Can't just leave it there, right?
No.
Well, there you go, ladies and gentlemen. That's the problem we're having. That is the meme.
Look, it was tasty, alright? You just don't throw food away. Look. There's a fucking difference if there's half-eaten burgers, because then there's saliva and shit on it. Like, even yours. Like, I probably shouldn't have had it, because you probably had your fork in your mouth, you probably had your fork inside of the kebab. Fuck it. Like, I know you, I'm not going to be as picky. Like, I know you don't probably, I really hope you don't have an STD.
I definitely have an STD now that Wada took us to that island.
That makes me slap the table. Even though the table is my idea. But no. Well, that was great because the kebab was before then. But with those half-eaten burgers, you don't know who's eating those. If I would eat those, I'd cut off the sides that have been eaten first.
All right.
And same with...
And you're going to throw those away.
Yeah, I mean, the side that had been eaten, of course.
Okay.
Yeah, and then I just eat the rest of it.
I think that's about it for me.
Well,
we're going to the final question, the most important question here on the Ohaiyo Nation Deep Dive. What?
There's more?
The one question is the most important question.
Mm-hmm.
Who is your favorite Ohaiyo Nationer and why is it me?
Well, because you're kind of like me, you know? You're a bit outspoken. Like, you know, you just actually talk and, like, you know, you're a bit of an aggressor. Like, you probably fulfill the devil's advocate better than I do. Like, I usually try to go for that stance and I just fail a lot of times. Now, if you want the actual favorite person.
Yeah. Go ahead.
It's probably just Sky, because I've talked to him most. Sky or maybe Cappy. Cappy is really cool.
Yeah, those are good answers.
Yeah. Well, it's also probably most generic answers, but fuck it.
Yeah. I love the question, because it's so different for everyone.
It's a very good question.
It shows how people react to it. By the way, I have some news coming up on my computer that apparently the calculations on your bad taste index were wrong. The trash waifu coefficient was not used, and you actually have a much higher bad taste index than previously thought.
Real quick, what's my who's my waifu?
I don't know.
Exactly. Fucking know, you retard.
It's not for me to know. It's for the scientists to know.
Yeah, fuck off. What a doxing way long ago. You don't even know. You had this opportunity. You fucking missed it. You missed it by a mile. Get wrecked.
Oh. Anyway, yeah. The numbers are in. Your bad taste index is way above legal levels. So you cannot be the God King of Ohaiyo Nation. In fact, you gotta go to Ohaiyo Nation jail. The police is at the door. Everyone in who listens to this, you're gonna have to vote for what is going to happen to Herpes after his sentence of a bad taste person.
I'm going to fucking stage a coup. I'm going to fucking take that position. Yes. Be ready, whoever gets crowned.
Anyway, before you get taken by police, Herpes, would you like to say anything more?
Oh, this cookie's really good.
Okay. Goodbye, everybody. Herpes, goodbye.
See ya.
Yeah.
See you in jail.